Welcome back to Pax Europiana, the Sunset Talks about Austrian-Albanian relation. I'm talking here on Durres, above Durres, beautifully in this place. I go it in step by steps. It's also connected to my Eisdorf phone storage, I have to admit. I still have to learn how to delete all the videos after I made them, because to keep my storage open for the next one. Yes, I will also learn how to cut all these videos together and then also to share it. I do this video because I'm not happy with the present state of Austrian-Albanian relations. We should do much more, and we have done in the past much more for Albania, and it's time to get it done. Albania should join, with the help of Austria, the European Union in 2024. It's a beautiful country, it has deserved membership, it cannot really reform outside the European Union. That's also one of the truths. So inside it's much easier, and this we have done also for Romania and Bulgaria, and the same courage we need. Yeah, I want to be very clear in the heat. The sunset is quite hot for me, but I want to be very clear. We're not doing enough for Albania, and we have to do more. We have this moral historic obligations from the last 150 years of effort. And now, unfortunately, the current Prime Minister Rama and our Prime Minister Kurz, they seem not to understand each other very well. Famously, Rama quipped when he took power in 2013, he said the great time of the Austrians in Albania is over, and he made his Minister of Finance, when he received me, made it also very clear, my advice is not needed, kick them out, and that's what happened. And then he managed the country with the help of the Italians and the Turks, and you know, that's of course, when you come 8 years later and afterwards and you see no progress, then you shouldn't be surprised. Because with the Italians and the Turks, they do also quite better back home, but they have the capacity to really reform Albania and contribute significantly, or serve as a role model for good governance, not so much. So it's time again for Austrian efforts here in Albania to bring real European standards in the construction industry, in the business world, in the competition reality. Austrian, you can call them Austrian, German, you can call them European standards, real European standards, yeah? In the construction industry, in the property register, in the construction permitting, in the whole way of doing business, to organize the society and to reform this country, to be ready to really be a full member, and a full member of the European Union. It's absolutely possible. And it should be, and it will be for the people much better. It will be much better also for business, for the property owners. It will be much better because their property will be worth something, and the prices will rise, and there will be obviously much improvement, and that's all possible. Historically, Austria did a lot. I already mentioned in my first video, this is the Alexander Museo University. He was the greatest Austrian Albanian. There's also Karl Ritter von Geger. And there are many other famous Austrian Albanians, and they have contributed to life in Austria. And there's also many Austrians who have contributed to Albania as much as they could, especially after the opening and the end of communism. There was major efforts to support Albania from the Austrian side. I have already mentioned Alois Mock in a video, and also Erhard Busek. There was also Franz Franitzky famously supporting the transition in 97. In order to re-establish democratic governance. And there was also major effort for many of the famous ambassadors, most famous Ambassador Raunig, who contributed a lot, also as the chair of OECD here. And there were many others who I maybe have not mentioned now, also in the Austrian government, friends of Albania. Mr. Schüssel, I know very well, he really cared for Albania. But unfortunately now it is not so good, and this is something maybe we should really re-evaluate and redesign. Albania needs the euro now. Austria has helped in the Montenegro and in Kosovo to euroize in 2002. The same we can do now for Albania, and that we have the capacities, and also then to really make sure that Albania, no matter what is the settlement with Bulgaria and Macedonia, is now starting fast track to get the status of candidate country it has already, but also to be then in the European Union 2024, and it's absolutely possible. We have to find a new understanding. We have also helped to create the state. never forget when Albania was created in 1912, it was Austria, of course, you know, the KNK monarchy back then, but it was Austria who had a vital role to get this done because of our strategic interests also, and to ensure that this country will be not massacred and there will be no genocide committed by the Serbian state against the Albanians. It was not only our strategic interest, but also the humanitarian interest to avoid a complete massacre here. And the Serbs were at that time already in Durres, and Austria put the ultimatum to the Serbian state to withdraw from Durres, which they then did. And later, obviously, there was all this mess with the assassination of Franz Ferdinand. You know my opinion already when you listen to it, that this was very much connected with the control of Durres, because it was this control of Durres which Serbia really wanted, and Austria was in the way, so Austria had to be dismantled, and that needed war. For that you needed to have a big kind of a September 11 style wild assassination, and that was the crown prince which had to go. He went down in Sarajevo in the Vitov Dan. Silly of him to go, but he went and he paid with his life, and then millions of Europeans paid for this scheme to be successful, to dismantle the Austrian-Hungarian monarchy and to have a successor state of it. In many ways, Yugoslavia of the kingdom was, at least the southern half, the successor state of this Austrian monarchy. And yes, the idea was obviously to get Albania in, but this was not to be, because they really didn't want to be massacred by the Serbs. So yes, we are now here, of course, in a totally different kind of situation. We are here peaceful. It's a NATO country already. I made a video about it. And the Austrian-Albanian relations have also been very good. You know, we made the Austrian school in the north, in Shkodra. There's an Austrian HTL. This is going very good, and many people go there. And it really is an island of European and Austrian education in the north of Albania. Obviously, there's a lot of connection with the north of Albania to the religion and history. And that's the only Austrian school which is not in a capital is up there in Shkodra. And that's a great contribution. Also, some other things Austria is doing, but the political support is missing, you know. There's of course support from investors, and there's these hydropower stations, and there's other stuff from the Austrian Development Agency. But the major big political push for union membership, and that should Austria take the lead, the same as Austria has created together with Italy. Of course not alone. You know, you cannot do big things alone. It shouldn't be Austria alone running like Don Quixote through Brussels and pushing for Albania and the EU membership. But it should be Sebastian Kurz leading this campaign, building friendships with the Italians, with the Dutch, reducing the Dutch fears of Albania and also the French. And now he's not doing that, and that's the problem. We really have to get to a new understanding here and work together very closely in the spirit of 1912, in the spirit also of the past, when Austria was one of the first countries then to open an embassy with communist Albania in 56. And then later also Austria very active to engage in Albania. The Rogner Hotel, an Austrian investment, already in 92, 93. They opened in 95, as far as I remember, in the center. And it's such a landmark. It was very courageous of this Corinthian entrepreneur to do it at that time. And Austria stayed also during the Black Days with Albania. There was a lot of support from the Austrian politics. Mr. Großruck is to be mentioned, and many others, who also in the terrible days of 96, 97, 98, and then during the Kosovo War, Austria was with Albania, and we had all our reasons for it. It was not the commercial interest, it was the political interest that the people here are better. And it was also not a big anti-Serbian ideas, but the idea was really that all Europe is at peace and free, united, and is...